Welcome back to the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. Joining me on Skype today is Jeff Crivello from Famous Daves of America. Jeff, great to have you.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Jeff, Famous Daves of America operates barbecue restaurants around the U.S. Just give our investor audience an overview of the company.
Sure. Famous Daves is known as America's Famous Barbecue. We were founded in 1994 by Dave Anderson in the backwoods of Wisconsin. Our first location was in Hayward, Wisconsin, and has grown to 33 states, Canada, Puerto Rico, and United Arab Emirates. Famous Daves has great barbecue, but we also have fantastic chicken and burgers.
Jeff, the company has also extended the brand into retail besides the stores that you have. Can you go into that business for me really briefly?
Sure. Our consumer packaged goods, or CPG business, has done fantastic for us over the last few years. It's owned by one of our franchisees, and it utilizes our rubs and sauces and distributes them into your local grocery store and big box retailers. We, as Famous Daves, collect a royalty on the sales, but it has been a great driver of our revenue.
So is that a significant portion of the revenue?
It's not a significant portion, but it certainly is extremely valuable to us.
Speaking about revenues, let's get to your Q4 results that you released on Monday. Famous Daves gained almost 6% to a little over $5 on its stock after the company reported earnings. What were some of the highlights here?
Yeah, we had a great fourth quarter. Net income was up over $1 million. Traffic was up over 6%, and same-store comps were up over 2%. So we view this as a successful quarter. We expect future growth to be similar, and we hope for a successful 2019.
You say traffic was up by 6%. To what do you attribute this increased traffic to?
We attribute the majority of it to third-party delivery and catering. Off-premise has been the name of the game. Off-premise has been our growth initiative, and it's really working well for us.
We see a lot of consumers going to something like a Seamless or a Grubhub. Are you seeing any kind of hurdles that you're facing in competing with those kinds of applications?
We're not competing with them. We're joining them. We use Grubhub. We use Uber Eats. We use all the major third-party delivery systems, and we find a lot of value in them. Our typical demographic of a customer that dines in with us is over the age of 40, and we're finding our demographic to be much lower than millennials that are using the third-party delivery system. So we know we have a new customer, a new demographic, and we find a lot of value in the platform.
I understand the company is expanding its menu and utilizing technology to increase its offerings. How is Famous Daves doing that?
We've added many new items to our menu, and those new items are also available via delivery. So we don't have a skinny down menu on the delivery platforms. You have the full menu available to you. And one of our initiatives in 2018 was to add and evolve the menu. Since Dave's has been around for 25 years, the menu hasn't evolved a whole lot. We feel that customers have. We are trying to catch up with that evolutionary process. So we added many new items, and those new items, as we call them, even more frequent items, are available via delivery.
So what other initiatives is the company taking in 2019 to continue this upward trend in revenues?
Growth in 2019 is the name of the game for us. We are refreshing many of our restaurants. We did a refresh in our Coon Rapids, Minneapolis location, and we saw a 10% lift. We are refreshing our Minnetonka location, our Westbury in New York location, and a few others that we have around the country. So we understand the refresh is extremely important, and it's part of our growth and traffic driving initiative.
And Jeff, really quickly, I want to get to some comments that I've seen you've say in other interviews, the fact that the company may be launching a chain of fried chicken ghost restaurants. Can you elaborate on that?
Sure. So on a large scale, most of our restaurants are 6,500 square feet and up. On a very small scale, we're developing a small footprint restaurant. But on an even smaller footprint, we are developing what's called a ghost kitchen, which is our fried chicken or burgers or however we choose to focus on whatever items those are. We will put those on their own menu and rebrand it and develop such as Famous Fried Chicken, which is produced out of our Famous Dave's kitchens. We don't have to build a new restaurant. We don't have to hire new staff. We have that. We have occupancy costs in line, and we will develop the and produce the food from our kitchens and deliver it to our customers via third-party delivery.
So when can investors expect for the rollout of those ghost companies to happen?
We would expect that to happen in Q2 2019 this year.
Great to hear, Jeff. Thanks so much for the update today and for the overview of the company. Thanks for your time.
Appreciate the time. Thank you.